Presentation on Antarctica, one presentation on Himalaya. I want to take you all to Arctic. So today I'm going to talk about diisopropylnaphthalene. In short, it is DIPN in Arctic fjord, that is Kongsfjorden, about its environmental significance. This is a part of my PhD work, which I have conducted in NCPOR. So when we say Arctic, we all think that it is a pristine, but we know that since several decades there are many papers which are telling us that Arctic is no more pristine, no matter it is far from the industrial area, but it is getting pollutants from the local sources as well as from the long range transportations. So the process through which they are getting pollutants there, it termed as global distillation. Global distillation process is nothing but it is a, like, you can consider it when the pollutant evaporate or enter into the environment, they travel through the air current and deposit it through the wet and dry deposition on land, water, soil, on any surface. And when the temperature increase, again they evaporate, they start their travel through the air currents, they deposit through the wet or dry deposition. So in this way, they move like a grasshopper. That's why we also term this process grasshopper effect. So they move like a hop, evaporate, settle, evaporate and settle. So once they reach to the Antarctica or Arctic, there is a cold temperature, we all know that. So after reaching there, they get locked there. After that, there will be no transportation. So this Arctic and Antarctica is considering as a sink for these pollutants. So in terms of my research, where in the Arctic I have conducted my research and what was the research quest behind that. So I have conducted my research in Kongsfjorden, which is located adjacent to the Ny-Ålesund. And this place, Ny-Ålesund, is considered as a research village where different countries, including India, have their research base. And along with the research activities, this place is getting attraction as a tourist hub. So nowadays there are many tourists who are coming to this place. So with this scenario in my mind, I was thinking that is Kongsfjorden facing any impact due to these human related or human induced activities in the Kongsfjorden, Ny-Ålesund? So why I have chosen DIPN? Because this DIPN have no natural source. It synthesized anthropogenically, and this DIPN is used as a plant growth regulator on potato skin. And this DIPN have a characteristic that they can remain in environment for long period, and they can migrate to water, atmosphere, and can contaminate the environment. So from environmental perspective, it become important to monitor these DIPN, especially in the sediment, to ensure that they should not reach to that level that they cause adverse effect in human or in the biota. I have collected samples from Kongsfjorden and analyzed them through, I have adopted the protocol that US EPA, and in brief I would say that I have extracted them with the salicylate extraction followed by the cleanup, silica gel cleanup, and analyzed them through the GCMS. And this all analysis I have done in NIOT under the guidance of Dr. Kiru Bagaran. From my analysis, I got result, and when I put it on the graph, I come to know that the concentration of DIPN is higher near to the Ny-Ålesund, where there are more human activities. And I come to know that the probable source of these DIPN are from the food packaging, especially the recycled cardboard cartons, from where it migrate to the food material, and from there they enter through the wastewater to the fjord, and they also enter into the fjord from the potato skin, where they have used as a growth inhibitor. So the question which I have raised with my analysis and my results, I would say that yes, the presence of DIPN is an evident sign that there is a contamination from the human activities there. And with this last slide, I just want to give you a take-home message that this the characteristic of DIPN, they are persistent, they are bioaccumulative, but there is a need for exercising cautions to ensure that the possible point source emission of this DIPN are controlled and that the concentration do not increase over time. So there is a need that we should continuous monitor this DIPN in this pristine area. Thank you so much.